This morning on Today's Kitchen, Patsy's Italian Restaurant. Of the thousands of restaurants in New York City, very few withstand the test of time, and only one can lay claim to being Frank Sinatra's favorite.
The first time my father met Sinatra, Tommy Dorsey brought him into our restaurant, and he said to my father, "Patsy, I want you to fatten up this kid. He's too skinny."
And for over 50 years, Frank Sinatra kept coming back, often with his buddies, along the way creating a star-studded clientele for Patsy's.
Almost every celebrity that you'll find in the Wall of Fame, in one way or another, you can trace back to Frank Sinatra. Come fly
with me. Sinatra brought Jackie Gleason, who then invited Tom Hanks. Rosemary Clooney came in with Frank. She then dined here with nephew George, who in turn escorted Julia Roberts. And Patsy's remains a Sinatra family tradition. The night we were here, Nancy Sinatra's boots walked right on in. You keep saying you got something for me. In the heart of New York's theater district, Patsy's authentic Neapolitan cooking is all about family.
Patsy's has been open for 59 years now, and there's only been three chefs. I'm the third generation chef here. Before myself was my dad, and before my dad as the chef was Patsy Pasquale, my grandfather.
Good evening.
And no matter who you are, Patsy's makes you feel at home.
Everybody is a special person that walks through that door. Everybody is a celebrity.
Especially Old Blue Eyes.
He was true to us like no one else. He was a friend. 'Cause they can't take that away from me.
All right, and all the family recipes. Yeah. As well as some great Sinatra stories can be found in Patsy's cookbook. Scott Mamillo is the executive chef of Patsy's Italian Restaurant. I have been there many times. Sal, it's good to see you.
Happy to be here this morning. Thank you.
You know what? I've come in and I've looked on the wall and seen the stars. I mean, you grew up in this incredible experience. Did you know what it was? I mean, could you appreciate it growing up?
You know, you don't realize it sometimes, some of the best things until afterwards, but I really did appreciate meeting some of my heroes, whether it was Frank Sinatra, Jackie Gleason, these people growing up. It was an incredible experience, mm-hmm. incredible experience. And only, I think the only time I got really nervous was when I actually met Sinatra.
Really?
That was a really nervous.
Do you remember the first time?
I do. Actually, we have a side entrance that he would come in. And we'd have to escort him up the side entrance. And there was a curtain that I had to hold back for him to come in. And I held it with my right hand. And that's when he extended his hand to shake my hand. I let the curtain go in front of him. I didn't sleep for 2 days. I was only 14. And you know, it was just how you say you're sorry. But he always made me feel at ease. Once I took over as the chef in 1985, full-time, I was trained by my dad. He would pop his head in the kitchen and say, "Hey, make sure you do as good as your pop, you know, so make you feel at ease, no problem."
There were so many great stories, but one I loved, there was a one-upsmanship story between Frank and Sammy Davis Jr., part of the Rat Pack. Tell us me that one.
One night upstairs, they were together upstairs, and they were doing that song, "Anything You Can Do, I Can Do Better." So Sinatra would do a little soft shoe, and then Sammy Davis would do a little soft shoe. Sinatra would sing the note, Sammy Davis would sing it over, and go back for a little while, and finally, Sammy Davis had enough with getting caught by Frank Sinatra. He took off his glasses and he pulled out his glass eye and rolled it around. He said, "Top that, Mr. Chairman." That was the end of the contest. He said, "You won." That was
You're going to make Frank's favorite dish.
This is one of the things he really loved, the veal cutlet mayonnaise. Mm-hmm. And what we do is we have some seasoned breadcrumbs here. We have some plain breadcrumbs.
Fresh breadcrumbs?
This is fresh breadcrumbs. We make it from the bread and the food processor. Of course, you can buy them. Mm-hmm. We add a little bit of parsley to it. If you could add a little bit of salt for me. A little oregano, some of the Parmesan cheese. A little fresh pepper, of course. Mm-hmm. And what really is nice here, if you could stir it up for me, is it stays moist by putting in the extra virgin olive oil. That really comes nice, and you can smell the cheese and everything. And it stays good for at least 2 weeks in the refrigerator.
Where did your grandpa and then your dad come up? Were they trained as chefs?
Actually, my grandfather learned on his own. He learned in Naples. Mm-hmm. And when he came to Italy, he came from Italy to here. He worked in many different restaurants, eventually opening his own called Patsy's. Okay. And he did a good job with it all these years. And he was the chef, and my father, and then myself.
Okay,
now
we have got the breadcrumbs.
We've got some already breaded here. Mm-hmm. We're going to start to fry these.
So you dip it in the...
Yeah, we're going to dip it first in the flour.
First in the flour.
And then we're going to put it in the beaten egg. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then we have the seasoned breadcrumbs already laid out here. You gotta have your one nice and hot. This way it's nice and crispy. We have some already ready here. Mm-hmm. This way you can get them frying up nice. And that's the way he liked them. We used to pound them very, very paper thin for him.
Right.
Because they come crispy that way. And if the oil is hot, then you won't absorb as much of it.
So you got to be careful as you add more and more in because the temperature will drop.
It cools down the temperature. You don't want to crowd the pans. Mm-hmm. Just enough like that. In about 2-3 minutes, they're done.
You know, so many people have said, "Geez, Sal, why don't you guys? I mean, you're so successful. Why don't you expand? How come there's only the one Patsy's?"
Well, we have, you know, just the one and all in one location on West 56th Street. There are other places with similar names not affiliated with us. But where we expanded really was our cookbook now, right. And we have our dried pasta sauces, right. Patsy's pasta sauces. We sell all over the country.
Right.
So that's something we felt we could keep a better control on, mm-hmm. than opening another restaurant because we are control freaks.
Because there's just you and your dad,
my yeah. father, my and cousin. And we have, you know, we trust them behind the register, only family members. And I make sure,
you know, hey.
Expand, you got to have more family. Oh,
this is cooking up. Tell us what else you've got.
We have some other dishes that are in the cookbook. We have the rigatoni sorrentino, which is baked rigatoni with three cheeses, Parmesan Reggiano, ricotta, mozzarella.
And really quick, how long on each?
About 2 minutes. It's almost ready to turn now. Okay. If you want to give them a flip, we can do that.
Okay.
And that's it. See, they're getting nice and brown there.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. So, you know, the thing is not to burn them and not to put too much, you know, at a time, otherwise they start to burn.
Right. And what else do you, is that like a
timbale of pasta we have here, which is very popular. It was made popular in Big Night, the movie Big Night. And that's a beautiful, beautiful dish made with penne pasta. There's an eggplant on the outside, fried mm-hmm. eggplant on the outside. Another one of Frank's favorite was the stuffed artichokes that we have over there. Here's some finished veal cutlet Milanese here.
Blow on that.
Yeah.
It's a little bit hot.
You want to feel it.
And we have the
tiramisu.
Tiramisu is the most popular dessert since 1988.
Okay.
And we have the chopped salad, which seems like a simple dish of iceberg lettuce, pimento, anchovy, a little bit of oil, and we use Cabernet vinegar, you know, red wine vinegar, no balsamic. Mm-hmm. It's just a simple thing, and it just sells so well.
What was the most popular dessert before 1988?
Well, we always sold the cheesecake. We thought the cheesecake was very good. Good question, actually.
All right. If you want to check out the recipes, take a look on our website at today.msnbc.com. Sal, thank you so much.
My pleasure. Always a, thank you very much.
My good friend. Thank you, Sally.
Oh, that's good. I hope you enjoyed it.
Hey, listen. Before we go, we want to thank Mr. Jay Leno one more time.
Yeah. Thank you.
Not okay?
If your nighttime TV gig doesn't work out, you could try TV in the daytime. You did just fine.
And Kate, we have a future.
Katie's going to be doing your show tonight.
Yep.
What's the last minute advice for her?
Be afraid.
Be afraid.
She'll be on the Tonight Show this evening. Check it out at 11:35. That's 10:35 Central Time. She trades places with Jay later in the week and trades places with soccer superstar Mia Hamm. Al with one of the finest chefs and restaurateurs in the world.
Other than Sal. Danielle Ballou.
And I will trade places with a New York City cabbie named Dave.
I think you ought to have Jay drive for you.
I think we'll pass on that. You're a good sport. Good to have you. Well, today-